I am S.R. Dulange, working as an associate professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we will discuss on dimensions of quality. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to apply and analyze the dimensions associated with quality. Contents. Dimensions of quality. Under that, first is quality of design, second is quality of conformance, third is quality of performance. Then we will discuss on factors affecting quality of design and quality of conformance. References. Dimensions of quality. Under that, the first is quality of design. It is the intention of designer to include or exclude features in a product or service, that is, degree to which the quality characteristics are embedded to the product or service. So this is at the design stage. What customer is demanding, it has to be included in this quality characteristics. So what are the characteristics? Now, there are certain quality characteristics which are technological. For example, strength. For example, temperature, viscosity, pressure. There are certain quality characteristics like contractual, that is guarantee, warranty. There are certain quality characteristics which are time oriented, that is reliability, maintainability. So these quality characteristics are to be achieved at the design stage, that is called as quality of design. Product or service must at least minimally meet the needs of the customer. Now, this is what quality of design. Now, what is good quality of design? Consistent performance over stipulated period is nothing but a good quality of design. So, it can be measured in terms of output, in terms of efficiency, in terms of overload capacity for a particular product. It should also consider certain possible modes of failure. Right? It should withstand stress, wear, distortion, corrosion, vibrations, high or low temperature, certain environmental conditions. For example, if you take car as an example, now in a manufacturing sector, now the Ford is one company, second is BMW. Now what makes the difference between these two? The features of this car: performance, size, quality and cost. So this is available for the customer. Now the customer will choose based on his need. Both companies are satisfying the needs of the customer. But one can go for a Ford and one can go for a BMW. In a service sector, we take an example of hotel. Economy versus five hotel. So what is the difference? Comfort, luxury, ambience and service. So this makes a difference between an economy and five star hotel. Now, good quality of design in the manufacturing sector as well as in the service sector basically aims to satisfy the customer. Now, what are the factors controlling quality of design? So, the first factor is type of customer in the market. Now, what is the consuming habits of people? We must have to do the market research in order to study what is the consuming habits of people. So it is specifically true for the consumer goods. So FMCG industries is looking after the consuming habits of people. Second, prices they are willing to pay. So it varies from city to city. It varies from nation to nation. So based on that, we can have a quality of design. Third is choice of design. So it is based on need and feedback of the customer. What is the need of the customer and what feedback he is giving for a particular product? Second is, for capital goods, good quality of design means based on its intended life, reliability, maintainability and how it behaves in different environmental conditions. Third is profit consideration. Naturally, any manufacturing industry or service industry is doing a business in order to earn the profit. So you should produce good quality product. So that is nothing but a good quality of design. So certain products have the special requirement, that is in terms of strength and fatigue resistance. So that is nothing but a good quality of design. Even the quality of design is nothing but the tightness of specifications. Now think for a moment, high quality of design means what? High quality of design is nothing but high cost, but it also leads to high value. Second dimension is quality of conformance. It means how well the product or service meets the specifications determine the designer. Now this quality of conformance is nothing but a quality of manufacturing. How you are manufacturing the product which will satisfy the design or the needs of the customer. How well the manufactured product conforms to the quality of design is nothing but the quality of conformance. Let us take an example of manufacturing sector. If suppose the production product dimension of 28 plus minus 0.10 mm, its size can vary from 27.90 to 28.10. So if we achieve these dimensions, naturally it is called as quality of conformance. If suppose we take an example of service sector, hotel industry. If suppose the promised service time is 20 minutes and if we get a service within 20 minutes, so that is nothing but a quality of conformance or good quality of conformance. Now what are the factors controlling quality of conformance? Incoming raw material is the first. That is, optimum quality should be maintained as far as the raw material is concerned. Machine, tools and measuring instruments must be kept at high level of maintenance. Selection of process and process control that can be done by means of certain statistical quality control tools and by planning. Well-trained, experienced and motivated operator. So training should be given to the operator. There should be experienced and motivated operator in order to achieve a good quality. Handling care should be taken in work in process and storage. Good inspection program, measure of efficiency. Feedback from customer. So that is the corrective action taken when the customer gives the feedback. SQC, that is statistical quality control. The variability of the product can be controlled by means of SQC. Now the third dimension of quality is quality of performance. The quality of performance is associated with the reliability of the product. Product is performing its intended function under a prescribed set of conditions. It extends to robustness as well. So if the quality of design is good and the quality of conformance is good, means we can achieve a good quality of performance. Now the quality of performance is very helpful in order to stay in market, because the customer will be happy if the product behaves with its intended function. So the performance should be very effective for every product, and it is true for the manufacturing sector as well as for the service sector. In the manufacturing sector, let us take an example of voltage stabilizer. If suppose the voltage stabilizer is designed for a voltage of 190 to 270 voltage, means it has to do the performance between these two voltage. Now if you take a service sector as an IT industry, if suppose the product of an IT industry is antivirus, so it should be updated as far as the time is concerned. So regular updation should be there as far as this antivirus is concerned. So quality of performance depends on quality of design and quality of conformance. Now these are the references.